What's up guys, Antolis here. Today I wanna talk with you how to promote a new website from scratch if you have no audience, traffic, and you just want to get it, because I see this problem all the time when new websites try to outrank big and popular websites. Don't do it. It's better to find your way, because popular websites usually cover a lot. They take all high volume keywords, but they can't cover everything. 15% of new keywords appeal every day. It's better to find your way where you can get this attention and you don't need to waste a lot of resources, because I see this problem when webmasters try to outrank Amazon, Booking, Expedia, or many other websites. Don't do it. Watch this video until then and you will know exactly where you need to go. Stay tuned, the best part is coming. Before watching this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video, and click the notification tag to know about new videos on this channel, because I create this video for you in order to make you a better marketer. Okay, let me share my screen where I show you the way that you need to go. Okay, first you need to start from websites that provide information about authority. I usually use Ahrefs, you can use SEMrush, Moz, or anything else. These websites have a lot of options. That's why if you open my website SEO Tools TV and click SEO Tools, you will find the first filter, multi-purpose, and here you can find these websites. Ubersuggest, you can use this great tool from Neil Patel. SEMrush you can use, SimilarWeb, Ahrefs, Moz, or Majestic SEO, SERPstat, many other great tools. What you need to do to estimate or measure authority of your competitors. For example, if you start from scratch, you have no traffic, it's better to compete with websites that have a low level of authority. Just take one of these tools and check out the level of competition, and ignore websites like Amazon, Wikipedia, or many others, because you can't outrank them if you start from scratch. It takes years to take these positions. Okay. It's first step when you estimate your level of authority. I just wanna tell one thing, that Google doesn't recognize authority from these tools, because Google has own peer algorithm. But according to numerous studies, we can see that more authority, more traffic. Yeah, we have this ratio, that's why you need to pay attention with this. Okay, the next step, what you need to do, create more info content. I see this problem all the time when new websites try to outrank popular websites to create e-commerce content, but they have no authority, trust. Why people need to buy from them? 70% of buyers don't buy from unrecognizable brands. The best way to cover their attention is to create info content. For example, for my projects, I create more info content than e-commerce one. That's why I have my blog. You can open my website and analyze my videos, my text-based content, or anything else. I just submit all this information, and I also post on YouTube and LinkedIn, because I need to get attention, and it covers all the stages of sales funnel. When people meet your brand 7 times, it's a big chance they will buy from you. That's why you need to pay more attention with info content. Forget about e-commerce one before you get the first traffic. I see this problem even with affiliate marketing, when webmasters try to sell products without having a loyal audience, you should get loyal audience first, and after this you can submit your links or affiliate links. It depends on your purposes. Just get traffic first with info content. The next step, what you need to do to create the right strategy. I use Ahrefs, you can use or any other tools. I usually go to Content Explorer, where I type keyword. I just took Instagram keyword, you can use yours, and I have options: first publish over then 3 years, English, referent domains to 5, because I don't want to compete with big websites that have a lot of backlinks. I even use less authority than 30 words, over 1,000 words, and organic traffic more than 1,000 people, and you can see that Ahrefs found 496 pages. Check out them manually and think, for example, we can open the first one and you can see that can you create something better, much better, because I see when some webmasters ask me why I need to create something better if my competitors have less quality content. They might occupy the top 10. If you wanna get there, if you want to get their traffic, you need to outrank them to create something better, much better, because your competitors might get the top 10 because of their links, authority, trust. That's why it's better to create much better content and take the chance to outrank them. And here you can see that we have some article, not big, small article, not a lot of words, but we have a lot of comments. It's user-generated content as well, not bad. That means it's a big chance for you to create something better, just to rewrite this article, to use fresh information and add to your blog. You can get this traffic and sales, why not? Pay more attention with info content, with blog articles, when you use this tool, and check out some articles and analyze user intent. For example, if you see the list of tips, create list of tips. If you see some information about how to, just create it. It's essential to provide what people wanna get, not you wanna rank, because I see when webmasters create e-commerce content and they want to get traffic. But how you can do it? Perhaps your customers might want get another type of content. Just analyze it, because Google provides a good job, to find what people want to get. Okay, the next step, what you need to do to launch your tools. For example, if you open my website and click SEO tools, you will find that I have my list of tools. Tools are great because, when you create info content as I do on your blog, people read one time your article and forget about your article. Yeah, it will be great if they share your article, if Google ranks them. When you have your tools, people might get back to your website to use these tools more time. And some people can get a lot of times, numerous times, to your website and share your tools. It doesn't cost a lot. Just go to Upwork, find some freelancers who create tools, and analyze your niche, what type of tools you need to have. Don't try to copy existing tools. For example, if you check out my tools, you can see that I have my unique tools, for example, Keyword Clusterizator. Please, if you know the same tool online, just send me the link, because this tool group a list of keywords for a few seconds. I want to see just one tool. And you know why I create this tool? Because I can show on my screen, you can see that I add a list of keywords, a few keywords tool doesn't recognize because of special symbols. I don't think that these keywords need to someone. You can see that I add 4,600 keywords, and the next step, just click search and you get group of keywords for a few seconds. I created this tool because I provided this job manually, as many other webmasters usually do, and you can see that for a few seconds I can group a list of keywords and get great results. I don't waste my time, resources to provide this job manually, and yep, you can use other special features. What you need to do, analyze your niche and think what type of tools you can provide. For example, if you help people to lose their weight, just create weight loss calculator and or anything else. Just check out existing ones, and if you see that you can update them or create something better or even create unique tool, just do it, you know, because when you share your tools, people get back to your website, and yep, you get the loyal audience and direct traffic. Yeah, that's good. And my last tip is to promote on social media. It's better to choose one social media if you have limited resources. If you have a team, yeah, just why not, you can give all social media to different people in your team. But if you are alone, choose one. And I use LinkedIn because I love LinkedIn. I can get a high level of engagement, and if you open my posts, you can see that I usually post a lot and get a lot of traffic, views, likes, other engagement. You know why? Because I try to promote my social media accounts on Facebook and Instagram, but I lost my attention to one platform, and I usually get 50 followers a day, but today I can get 300 followers on LinkedIn alone, because I don't waste my time with other social media. And you can see that I mix my content. I don't post only about my niche, and yeah, because people on social media have different mindset, and yeah, you can mix some type of content. I promote my YouTube here, and yep, and I usually post only valuable content without trying to sell, because webmasters reach out to me and ask me for help. They wanna order my service. Yep, nothing special, just provide more value as maximum as possible. And for example, if you use LinkedIn or Twitter or Facebook, you can post a lot. And if you want to promote your account, just comment other influencers' accounts, because if you provide value to their posts, you can get attention from their followers, and yep, it helps to promote your LinkedIn. And you know, I don't want to tell that you need to use any social media with only one purpose, to help your SEO. Of course not, because 3 billion people on social media, you can get real sales, results, and to promote your brand. Just pay more attention with info content. Okay guys, ask me any questions in the comment sections. Tell me, what do you think about my tips? If you need any help, just reach out to me. I will help you and lead you to the right direction, and even I can provide a free analysis for your website. Okay guys, thanks for watching this video. See you next time. Cheers.